AutoLine Daily is brought to you by BorgWarner. Feel good about driving. Bridgestone. Your journey, our passion. And by Dow Automotive Systems. Improving durability and increasing design flexibility with Betamate structural adhesives at DowBetamate.com.
Hello and welcome to AutoLine Daily, where we work to keep you on top of the latest developments in the global automotive industry. BMW just announced it will start building the new Mini Hatch in the Netherlands of all places. The car will be built under contract at VDL Nedcar, a facility that used to be part of a joint venture between Volvo and Mitsubishi. The Mini Hatch is also produced at the company's main production site in Oxford, England. In addition to the UK, Minis are also built in Austria. Well, it's official. China's largest auto supplier, Wangxiang, now owns Fisker, thanks to an auction bid of $149 million. As you may remember, Wangxiang also bought A123 Systems, the company that supplied Fisker with its batteries, so you can see where this is going. The new Ford F-150 is 700 pounds lighter than its predecessor thanks to its aluminum-intensive body. But that's not the only area where Ford cut weight on the truck. It was able to shed 30 pounds just from the front seats with the use of high-strength steels. The automaker enlisted help from about a dozen heavy-set men to get in and out of the trucks to test and improve the durability of the seats. The end result was a lighter seat along with a tougher leather that can help them withstand a constant beating. Last week, we reported about a sinkhole that opened up at the National Corvette Museum and swallowed some one-of-a-kind Corvettes. Well, Chevrolet has taken matters into its own hands and will have the cars restored at the General Motors Design Studio. AutoLine's Executive of the Year, Mark Royce, is spearheading the project, while the Vice President of Design, Ed Welburn, will oversee the restoration. And no doubt about it, those cars are worth it. The European market is starting to show some signs of revival. The European Automobile Manufacturers Association, or the ACEA, says new car sales were up 5.5% last month. That's the fifth month in a row that European sales have gone up. Analysts are not calling this a rebound. Instead, they say the European auto industry is now moving from survival to revival. Speaking of Europe, the German market is one of the most important in the world, with over 3.2 million vehicles sold there. But do you know who the major players are? When it comes to selling passenger cars and light trucks, the top 10 list of automakers starts with the Volkswagen Group, which dominates the market with 38% market share. Then there is a big drop down to Daimler. BMW and GM are kind of close in sales, but the GM number includes about 24,000 Chevrolets, so look for Ford to surpass GM this year as Chevy gets yanked from the European market. Thanks to Dacia, Renault just squeaked ahead of Hyundai and Kia, which are surprisingly strong in Germany, beating out all the Japanese automakers. The Fiat Group and Toyota round out the top 10 list. Even though sales were down last year, Germany remains a big and very profitable market to be in. Yesterday, we showed you Renault's new Twingo. Now it's Peugeot's turn to show off its all-new small city car, the 108. For the first time, the car will be offered in either a hatchback or a retractable fabric roof configuration, which are available in 3 or 5-door models. It can be powered by one of 3 1-liter three-cylinder engines or a more powerful 1.2-liter three-cylinder engine, and they're all mated to either a 5-speed manual or 5-speed automatic. The new 108 makes its debut at next month's Geneva Motor Show. The Chevrolet Corvette has used fiberglass body panels ever since it went into production in 1953. But the newest version of the car uses a new type of fiberglass. It's one of the tech secrets that AutoLine got the Corvette's chief engineer to talk about, and that is coming up next.
Proven on the track and on roads around the world, BorgWarner turbochargers improve fuel economy and reduce emissions without sacrificing performance. BorgWarner, official turbocharger supplier to the Izod IndyCar Series.
So much has been written about all the new technology in the C7 Corvette, but not everything has been reported about. Recently, we ran into Taj Jukter, the chief engineer for the Corvette, and asked him to let loose with some of the secret nuggets that have not yet seen the light of day.
Traditional fiberglass is a resin and glass mixture. It's been used since the 53 Corvette, but it's been evolving over the years. Lower density, higher performance modulus, and we have a true innovation on the C7 Stingray. It's called Carbon Nano Hybrid. So it's a mixture of glass reinforced with carbon fiber. Instead of a traditional filler material, we actually use nano clay. If you looked at it under an electron microscope, what you would see is this nano clay, which helps reduce the density of the material, but also helps it improve structurally because it's corkscrew shaped. And as you fabricate a panel, which is like a pressure process, you squeeze the glass and carbon strands together, and the nano clay actually entangles in the corkscrew shape, binding the whole mess together to create a lighter and stiffer panel. It's actually more attractive than the kind of traditional gray fiberglass, so it looks better, it's lighter, and it's stiffer.
You know, I'm still not sure that we've dug up all the info on the new Corvette. I got a sneaking suspicion there's still more to learn. Anyway, that wraps up today's show. Thanks for watching, and please join us again tomorrow.